Hello, we're joined by IBO World Champion Anna Rankin at the Boxing Film Festival, Boxer. How are you, Anna?
I'm really good, thank you. How are you?
Very good. What brings you here today? Are you part of the organization of the festival?
Or I'm going to be one of the panelists for the festival, so I'm really looking forward to it. I'm going to be working with Jane Couch on the panel for Million Dollar Baby, so yeah, really exciting.
Thank you for bringing up Million Dollar Baby. I want to ask you, you think that in the history of boxing cinematography, you think that female characters are as discriminated as female fighters have been in the actual boxing world? There are more Rocky movies than Million Dollar Baby movies.
Yeah, that's true, but then I feel like obviously men have been boxing for a little bit longer, so it's probably a slightly fairer representation, but nowadays we've got so many more women in the sport, so
that's a fair point.
I'm really looking forward to seeing more women get involved, which is going to be
great. That's a fair point. We need a bit of more history into female fighting.
There's some fascinating history about women actually boxing in the Victorian era, which is a whole time before, you know, and they actually first started, there were some championship fighters then, you know, prize fighters, and actually they were earning good money. So it's a pretty interesting sort of history about that, but it's a past that not many people know about.
Okay, I hear many people tonight telling me how they got into boxing because of Rocky. What does make by the way, good looking lady like you decide to get punched in the face? How did you get into it?
Well, I used to do taekwondo when I was really young. I've always loved combat sports. It actually appeals to me because the discipline is very similar to classical music, which is my other career. And I just love the sport itself. You know, when I got introduced to it, my coach, Noel Callan, I fell in love with it. And, you know, it's always something new to learn. It's properly exciting. And every different opponent is different. So, yeah, no, I really love it.
Listen, your favorite boxing movie of all time?
Oh, I don't know. I think I'm going to be a big Rocky fan. It's like one of those things, you know.
Yeah, but which one? There's too many of them. You have to pick one.
First
Rocky one?
Yeah,
okay, great choice. Good choice. Good choice. Listen, and if they made a movie about you, who would be playing you?
Oh, I don't know. Actually, I have no idea who would play me. Somebody that can maybe...
Is Scarlett Johansson?
Oh, thank you. I'll take that as a real compliment. Thank you.
No, but seriously, who would play you?
Oh, I couldn't think. There's a lot of different things to think about when it comes to female actors, but probably someone who's roughly... He's into their sort of action stuff, but also maybe knows a little bit about music as well, so it's a difficult one to answer.
Okay, listen, who's your top three of female pound-for-pound fighters? Your top three?
Top three. I have to say Cecilia Brackhouse is up there, Casey Taylor at the moment, and somebody that I fought recently, Clarissa Shields, up at the higher weight classes. You know, she's definitely doing it for the, you know, middleweight fighters, and she's leading the way, and lover or hater, she's a great fighter, so she's at the top three for me at the moment, yeah.
Okay, last question, and I ask this to everybody, and I want your take as well. Do you think that boxing cinematography is actually good in terms of attracting the casual to the sport, or paradoxically, either by setting unrealistic expectation as the Rocky movies, no? Because magari you see Rocky IV, then you go to watch a real fight, and maybe you get a very tactical cagey affair, and you listen, or by actually or even worse, the realism. When you show the really ugly side of boxing, like Million Dollar Baby is a tragic movie in the end.
Yeah,
no?
I know.
So what do you think? You think that the boxing cinematography is good for the sport?
I think everything should have a fair representation on the screen. Like when you go to see a film about a particular sport, you want to know all about it. You want to know the highs and you want to know the lows as well. So personally, I think it's important that we show all aspects of it. Rocky shows the more sort of like the exciting side of it, you know, it's over the top and, you know, all the entertainment things and showy stuff, and then in Million Dollar Baby there is a sad side of it as well, you know, there are sad things to think about and also really stressful things and hard work that you have to put in to like achieve anywhere in the sport. So, you know, especially as a female fighter, is that for me that there's a lot of things that resonate. So I think it's a good thing that we have all aspects covered on screen, and I think for people who've never ever watched any boxing, it's great for them to watch a film and actually, you know, maybe they'll go and go and see a real show to see what they think, see if they're actually really enjoying it.
But that's my point. But what if the show turns out to be a tactical affair, like I mean, if I watch a Rocky movie and then I go to and I get Roy Jones Jr. versus Bernard Hopkins, you know.
Yeah, but I think with with a Rocky movie, it shows the excitement. Mm-hmm. And if you're going to go and see, as a casual boxing fan, you're probably going to go and see the most exciting heavyweight fights or something like that. So it's not like you're going there to watch some more of the lower weights, which maybe a real boxing fan is probably into. Yeah. So I think it's a good thing. You know, once people start going to see heavyweight fights, the main title fights, they're naturally going to be able to see more of the cards and get involved in more of the technical side of boxing.
Well, Anna, thank you very much for your time. All the best for the future.
Thank you very much. Thank you.